Sleipnir, also known as the Sliding One, is the eight-legged horse of the god Odin. Sleipnir is one of Odin's many shamanic helping spirits, ranks that also include the Valkyries and Huginn and Munin, and he can probably be classified as a Valgur. Odin rides Sleipnir on his frequent journeys throughout the nine worlds, which are held in the branches and roots of the world tree Drisel. Sleipnir is a lesser known one among hundreds of mythical creatures. That said, Odin's horse did make a large enough impact and was mentioned in many Old Norse poems. These poems relate Norse mythology and German legends. Sleipnir is described as a large, muscular horse with eight legs instead of four. His extra legs are coupled with his regular legs, growing from his shoulders and his haunches. In some depictions of Odin riding Sleipnir, the mighty horse's extra legs are shackled to his regular legs at the knee. Other works of art show him using all his legs independently. Sleipnir's coat is as gray as a thundercloud, and his mane and tail are streams of darker gray. In one story, a Valkyrie mandates that Norse runes should be carved into Sleipnir's teeth. Sleipnir was born when the god Loki shapeshifted into a mare and became pregnant by the stallion of a giant, as is recounted in the tale of the fortification of Asgard. The tale of Sleipnir's birth is among the most extensively surviving written records of the horse. According to Norse mythology, following the war between the two factions of gods, the Æsir and the Vanir, the wall that surrounded the realm of the Æsir was destroyed. Fortification was pertinent to the survival of the gods, otherwise they would have constantly been at risk, and vulnerable to, an attack by their primary enemies, the giants. To rebuild this wall around Asgard, the gods hired a stonemason called Blast, or Hrimthurs, to rebuild these walls in three seasons. However, Blast's payment was the hand of the goddess Freya, the sun and the moon, a deal the gods were not willing to make. Loki, trickster he was, saw an alternative route. He convinced the gods to agree to the terms Blast proposed, assuring the gods that the payment would never be made. The gods trusted Loki to protect Freya, and the deal was struck. However, they stipulated that no man could help the builder, but he was allowed to be aided by his horse. Blast brought along a powerful stallion, Svithilfari, to help him with the heavy lifting. Svithilfari aided Blast in building the wall far quicker than the gods had imagined. They soon found that the builder and his stallion were equal to their task. The stallion hauled enormous rocks to the building site day in and day out, and by the time the project's deadline approached, it was clear the builder would finish his work. The gods turned their wrath on Loki, but Loki still had some tricks up his sleeve. That same night, he shapeshifted into a beautiful mare and went out to attract the builder's stallion. Sure enough, the stallion tore away from the builder and pursued the mare into the forest. They mated long into the next morning, preventing Blast from completing the wall before the agreed upon deadline. Having failed in his end of the deal, Blast therefore would forfeit Freya's hand. It was then that Blast revealed himself to be more than a mere stonemason, but a giant himself. He was dispatched of quickly by the hammer of Thor, Jonah. Some version of the tale claims it was Odin who dispatched the giant. Some time later, Loki gave birth to Sleipnir. Months later, Loki arrived at Asgard and presented Sleipnir to Odin as a gift. Despite being the product of the devious god Loki and a stallion belonging to the banished race of giants, Sleipnir was accepted by the Norse gods and proved to be a noble-hearted ally. Sleipnir later has a child of his own, an exceptional young stallion named Granny. Granny takes after his father in size, coloration, and strength, but he doesn't have eight legs. It was Odin who eventually rode Sleipnir. During his journey in search of more knowledge and during the Battle of Ragnarok, Odin rode on Sleipnir. One of the most famous journeys these two took was to the underworld, known as L in Norse mythology. The valiant horse also proved to be priceless on a trip to the underworld with Hermod in bargaining for the return of Balder's life. He guided Hermod through 9 nights of dark valleys, where the god could see nothing. Then, he carried Hermod over the Gjolbra and down to the gates of Hel, which he cleared in one mighty leap. Being a horse bred from Asgard and a powerful stallion, Sleipnir was gifted with various abilities including traveling over land, air and sea. None of the elements slow him down. It is because of these gifts that he has also likely been associated with shamanism, a shamanic guide, as Sleipnir is born with the ability to transcend the various realms of the world. According to the Icelandic sagas, Sleipnir does play an important role in helping to carry the dead to the other world. Legends involving Sleipnir can be found in Norse mythology, but he left his mark in different folklores carrying on his legacy. A canyon named Aspiki in Iceland has the shape of a horseshoe. Sleipnir was attributed great power in Icelandic folklore, and it is believed that this valley is one of his footprints. Sleipnir was depicted on some stones found in Sweden. His journey to Hel with Odin is a popular theme seen in ancient works of art. As a magnificent creature of Norse mythology, Sleipnir surely was a source of inspiration for Scandinavian people. Some Norse warships were named after the steed of Odin. Time and again, between 1877 and 1992, Norwegian Royal Navy named some of its ships after Sleipnir. Industry is not the only sector where Sleipnir's name was used. There are 2 sports clubs named after Odin's horse, one in Sweden and the other in Norway. The name Sleipnir is also used for a search engine on iOS, Windows and Android devices, and also as a horse character in an online game called Final Fantasy XII. Sleipnir is considered as the shamanic horse par excellence, just as Odin is as the shamanic god par excellence.